Hello, dear friends. Today, we are going to discuss limits and continuity. This is the fifth chapter in our book. Suppose that you are trying to walk out of a door, and the rule is that you are going to walk the half of the distance to the door at your first step. At your second step, you are going to walk half of the distance remaining. At your third step, you are still going to walk half of the distance to the door, and you continue this process. It's not difficult to guess that you will never be able to get out of the door. You will, of course, approach the door, and you are going to get closer and closer to the door, but you will never be able to get out of the door because there will always be a positive distance to the door. This is one of the most important concepts in mathematics, which is called the limit concept. Now, in order to understand the limit concept, let us approach a certain number, and let's say that number is 2, from with smaller and larger values. Now, let's take x equals 1.4, 1.5, 1.7, and we get closer and closer and closer to the point 2. Since we are approaching the point 2 with smaller values than 2, this approach is called approaching from left. We can also approach the point 2 from its right, meaning that we give greater values to the variable x, like 3, 2.5, 2.4, 2.01, 0.01, 0.001, and we can continue this process forever, and we can approach the point 2. Now, this is, as I said, the concept of approaching, the concept of limit, and in mathematical terms, we define it in the following manner. Let us given a function f from a set A to the real numbers, and let x approach the point x naught. Now, the point x naught may be the point we were talking about too, or some other point, but that doesn't matter, since it's an arbitrary point. X is approaching x2. If when x is approaching x2, the function f of x approaches a unique number l, whatever that value is, then we say that the function f has a limit at x equals x0, and that limit is called l, and this is denoted by this symbol. Now, let us investigate a couple of examples and see how the limits works. For our first example, we take the function f of x, piecewise defined function f of x equals x minus 1 if x is not minus 1, and 1 if x is minus 1. If you look at the graph of the function, when you approach the point minus 1 from right, you are going to see that the function's values are approaching to minus 2, and if you also approach the point from minus 1 from left, you are going to see that the function also approaches the same value, which is minus 2. However, the value of the function is not minus 2 at this point, and its actual value is 1. The limit of the function is minus 2, but at this point, the function has a different value. Now, this signifies a very important fact that the limit value of the function does not have to be equal to the value of the function at that point. And also, we should state at this point that it is sometimes very important to determine the behavior of a function at a given point, x equals x naught, say, rather than the value of the function at that point. Let's proceed with another example, and this time let us take this piecewise defined function, which is minus x squared plus 1 if x is less than 1, and x minus 1 if x is greater than 1. In this case, as we approach 1 from left or right, we see that the values of the function approaches 0. But at this point, it's interesting that the function has no value. If you look at the definition of the function, you are going to realize that the function is not defined at x equals 1, which is actually given by the domain of definition of the function. So we can still have a limiting value for a function which does not have a value. This means that the behavior of the function is known, but the value of the function is not given at all. Therefore, from these two examples, we can immediately see that the behavior of the function, or the limit of the function, to say it in a better way, the limit of the function may exist at a point x equals x naught. However, the function may not be defined or may have a completely different value at this point. So, what if, let's go to one-sided limits. Now we can approach, this is a very, by the way, this is a very important and very famous function, h of x, which is called the Heaviside function, named after a British engineer. And h of x is 1 if x is greater than 0, and x, it is 0 if x is less than 0. At x equals 0, the function jumps from 0 to 1, and we can approach x equals 0 from the left. So the limit of the function is 0, or from the right, and the limit of the function is 1. The limit of the first limit when you are approaching a point from left is called the left limit of a function. And if you are approaching to the point x0 from right, this limit is called the right limit of the function f. Now, let's just say that the limits of this function at x equals 0 from left and right, I mean, is not equal. So this is going to be important in that there is no limit, because as we were defining the limit of a function, we say that there must be a unique function, unique number L. However, here there's no unique number. There's a 0, there's a 1, which are not equal, so the limit does not exist. We may also have infinite limits. Let's consider this function f of x equals 1 over x squared, and let us approach x equals 0 from left or right, that doesn't matter. If you approach x equals 0, the values of the function starts increasing and increasing. As closer as you get to 0, the function will have huge and huge values. So the limit of the function f of x approaches infinity, and we say that the limit is infinity. We may also have limits at infinity. So instead of considering this function, let's say f of x equals 1 over x at x equals 0, let us consider this function at x equals infinity. So I'm approaching, say, minus infinity. What does the function do? The function gets smaller and smaller and smaller with negative values and approaches the point 0. What if I'm approaching to plus infinity? The function's values get smaller and smaller and smaller from positive values and approaches to 0. So limits at infinity of for this function is 0. What if the function we were talking about a few minutes ago, the limit of the function and the value of the function are the same? This is probably one of the most important concepts in mathematics, called the continuity. And let us define it. If we are given a function f from a set A to the real numbers, and if this function has a limit at x naught, at a point x naught, where the limit is equal to the value of the function, which is f of x naught, then we say that the function is continuous. F is called continuous at the point x naught. So the first thing is the function must be defined at x equals x naught. The second thing is the function must have the same value as its limit, or the limit must have the same value as the value of the function for the function to be continuous. Now let's consider this very famous function which we introduced at the very beginning. It's one of the most difficult functions to me, at least. It's the modulus of x, which is, well, absolute value of x, we call it, which is x when x is greater than or equal to 0. It's minus x when x is less than 0. Now we are just trying to understand whether this function is continuous. It seems that just by looking at the graph, we can see that the function is continuous to the right of x equals 0 and to the left of x equals 0, but there is a corner at x equals 0. Let's check the value of the function. If you look at the definition, you'll see that the function has value f of 0 equals 0. The left limit of the function is 0. The right limit of the function is 0. It means that, yes, it means that the limit of function f at 0 is 0, which is the value of the function, so f is continuous at x naught equals naught. There were functions which we introduced in our previous chapters. One of them is the exponential function and the other is the logarithmic function, and both of these functions are continuous on the domain of their definition. So they are continuous for the exponential function. The function is always continuous for all values of x. The logarithmic function is continuous for all values of x between 0 and infinity. Let's have a look at this function, which I can't remember which we considered at the very beginning, actually. X squared minus 1 over x plus 1 and 1. It's a piecewise defined function. This function is not continuous. The reason is very simple. When you look at the limit of the function at x equals minus 1, you see that the limit of the function is minus 2. However, the value of the function is not minus 2, but it is minus 1, its value. I'm so sorry, I have written it incorrectly. I'm sorry about that. The value of the function is 1. So the function cannot be continuous because its limiting value and its actual value are not the same at the point x equals minus 1. That's all for this chapter. So we'll see you in the next chapter, the derivative and the applications of derivative. But before that, I suggest you just go to the book and solve as many questions as you can and practice as much as you can. But the limit concept is very important because it forms the basis of the next subjects like differentiation and integral. Until next time, see you. Bye bye.